Hi everyone, my name is Antonio, as you read. I'm the CEO and co-founder of Ludwig. Ludwig is a startup, a software company that operates in the field of artificial intelligence and natural language processing. But it hasn't always been so. So since I was a child, my dream, my life, was becoming a professor of archaeology. And I did everything it took to reach my goal. I had my BA and later MA in Italy in archaeology. Then I moved to Spain and I got a second master and a PhD in history. Then I directed a research project in Sicily for 5 years. And I was doing the life I liked and I loved. This is my PhD thesis. No one read it probably but my mother. Took quite a while. And in my pursuit of becoming a researcher, a professor in archaeology, I had the first fellowship at the University of Granada and later on a postdoc fellowship at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology in 2013, 2014. Now, you know, a researcher's life is made basically of two things. One is publishing paper, and the other one is writing grants in order to get funds to publish more paper so that you can advance in your career. The rest of the time, a researcher's life is writing emails. And of course, all the writing that counts, all the writing that matters, is carried out in English. Which means that English is the single barrier. It's what makes the difference. If you want your paper published and grants approved, you have to write in excellent English. And this is shown by these numbers. 70% of papers are rejected because of poor English, regardless of the quality of the research itself. So you can have done a great research and still your paper gets rejected. This is a problem that doesn't affect me and academics. It's a problem for a lot of people around. The 1 billion non-native English users that ask themselves questions like, does my English sentence make sense? Am I expressing myself correctly? Or do I mean what I really mean? So, English is the vehicular language of the world. We all speak English more or less, and we are confronted with English writing all the time. So English doesn't belong anymore to those who were born in English-speaking countries, but English is ipso facto the language of the world as it was Latin in its times. So we should develop and create tools that help us communicate better. We should create our own tools that help us learn how to do so. And we should create tools that help us minimize the competitive advantage that natives have over non-native speakers. And since I was at MIT, I had this obsession. So in 2014, I came back from the US and I had a chance, a choice to make. I won a Marie Curie fellowship, which is like the most prestigious fellowship a researcher can aim for in Europe. And it was like a giant step forward in my dream of becoming a professor. On one side, so I was going to Germany, great fellowship. On the other side, I had this idea of starting this company and solving this problem once and for all. Of course, it was way more challenging, and it's of course what I did. And this is in 2014. I was in my city, back in my hometown, with Federico and Roberta. We were having beers, and this is actually how it happened. Federico and Roberta are two of my buddies and friends in school time. And they're both academics and have PhDs, so we share a lot of problem with writing. And we decide we'd start this company. And this is a cartoon another friend of us made about that night. We decided to take a new approach to language. We wouldn't focus on correct the user. Rather, we decided we would inspire the user. Because we think that English writing is not only about grammar or fixing a few misspellings. English writing is about inspiring, is about giving, helping the user find the best sentence to express what he thinks. So we built a linguistic search engine, sentence search engine, that helps people write better English, write inspired. This is how it works. You write a search, or your best guess of a sentence on a search bar. Our algorithm analyzes that sentence from a grammatical and a semantic point of view and compares it with a huge database made of 100 million of correct sentences coming from reliable sources and gives you examples of that sentence in context if it exists. And if it doesn't, it will show you the most similar sentences according to linguistic criteria so that you can find out if your sentence makes sense or how you can rephrase it and correct it. Of course, the context in which you're using it is extremely important. So we give you sentences to take inspiration from. We launched it in 2016, and so far we served already 20 million unique users. Last month we had 1.3 million unique users, and we have been growing at a 10% month-over-month growth rate for the last year. Satisfaction doesn't lie in numbers alone. I mean, satisfaction is knowing that we are helping hundreds of thousands of scientific researchers publishing their research, getting forward in their career, spreading their knowledge, and making the world progress. We are helping students passing exam, getting essays, and studying. We are helping teachers, businessmen, doing business, entrepreneurs. In particular, for instance, we helped a missionary, a Franciscan missionary, who was in Kenya, and he was raising funds in order to build wells, water wells in Africa. We helped Tanya, students, to get her master's degree. We received an amazing letter from her. So we are doing stuff that people care about and need. But the things I like most about Ludwig is that I'm working with my friends since school time, and we love working together. This is the entire team of Ludwig, very differently from Bosch. We are a very small team, just 6 people. But this demonstrates that even a small team can achieve also big things. We are 6, but we have a 7th member, whose name is Ludwig Wittgenstein, who is the father of philosophy of language. And he inspired us to give our company after him with this sentence of his, which is, "The limits of my language means the limits of my world." And then our domain is .guru, because we wanted to be like the guru of language. Thank you. That's it.